All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Gordon Neal. He's the new CEO of Whitehorse Gold. And Gordon, it's good to have you back again. How are you?
Yeah, I'm well, and I'm no stranger to proactive than you, Steve. So good to see you again and good to be back.
Yeah, exciting to have you on with this new company. And just so people who may not be familiar, have been around the mining game a long time, Gordon, give us a bit of your background.
Well, I started out with Mag Silver in 2003 with Dan McGinnis and Peter McGaw. On the corporate development side, and that turned out to be quite a success story. I mean, one of the largest silver finds in the world and still expanding and getting better. Learned a lot from those guys. It was kind of my my initiation. After that, I sort of took a little bit of a break, but decided that was on the exploration side and decided I wanted to learn about production. So, and in silver. Particularly. So I wound up meeting Ri Fang from Silver Corp Metals, flew me over to China. He's a guy, he's an entrepreneur who makes money for shareholders. I was interested in looking at operations and producing operations that actually could stand on their own and make money for investors. So I learned a lot from Ri about producing mines that are economic and can make money for investors. And then Ri asked me to run New Pacific Metals. So I was the president of New Pacific Metals for four and a half years, got it from exploration and discovery to a resource, a large resource. And then, of course, you're going to build it. I'm not a mine builder, but I'm certainly somebody who can take it from the exploration phase up to a production scenario. So then I got a call from Ri, who's the largest shareholder, and Mark Cruz, who's the chairman, and said, look, we want you to look at Whitehorse Gold. We know the current CEO is a mine builder, but we're not going to build a mine right now. We actually need somebody to come in and expand the resource. So my job, I'm sure is probably your next question, is where do we go from here? So I'll shut up for a while and let you go.
Well, that's what I was going to ask you. Is that the opportunity here with Whitehorse Gold? They seem to be in a sort of a sweet spot for your strengths.
Well, there's a couple of things. It's in a really good jurisdiction. And when I was working in Mexico, Mexico was a really good jurisdiction. Mag Silver was high grade, and so was Silver Corp in terms of silver, both of them. This is a great story. And you know, one of the things we used to do with Mag Silver is one of our ads was the silver crown, and it's because grade is king. When you're looking at a past producer in the Yukon, which is a great jurisdiction that produced 80,000 ounces of gold at almost 10 grams, you're talking grade, and grade is king. Grade will help economics. And as I said, what I've learned about this business is try to put together assets that can stand on their own economically and provide dividends to shareholders, right? That's, and I believe, given the past history of this, of the Yukon, or sorry, of the Skukum project, that we can do that. Now, it'll take expanding the resource first. It's at 600,000 ounces in all categories of a resource. And so we need to get it to 1 million plus for somebody to, you know, for majors or anybody to start taking it seriously. So my job is to get the team to use the drill bit to expand the resource, get it past that million ounce mark. And then, you know, and then down the road, look at bringing on a team possibly to restart the mill that exists there. The infrastructure is fantastic there. This is a good opportunity.
You mentioned the Skukum Gold Project. The company just had a news release out talking about exploration had been finished for this year. Does that give you sort of a clean slate now to see what was done this past year to set up what you want to do in 2022?
Yeah, the issue really, and I don't think we're alone, and I know we're not alone in this, is the assay labs are backed up so badly that you're looking at 9 weeks to get your numbers in. So even though we finished drilling in September, we've only got seven holes out. We've got 37 we're still waiting on, which will allow us to spread out some of these news releases as they come in and feed the market. But, you know, it is what it is, but we need to, you know, I wish I could go down to the labs and get them to move faster, but we're all in the same boat. So once those numbers come in, I'll get them out. And then the data that we receive from that will allow us to plan for the 2022 drill program, and we'll get that out to the market as well.
Well, Gord, congratulations on the new role. I know it's exciting for you. Look forward to talking again real soon.
Thanks, Steve. See you soon.
All right, there's Gordon Neal, the new CEO of Whitehorse Gold.